Hello everyone, this is Rajat from Real Studios. So in today's video, we are going to learn about common terms we use in React ecosystem. So let's get started. Before we start, make sure you subscribe to Real Studios YouTube channel for more videos like this one. So let's head over to our main video. ECMAScript 2015, also known as ES6, is a next specification of ECMAScript programming language, which JavaScript language is an implementation of. So it gives you several new features like let and const keywords and array destructuring and all. Although this language is not yet fully implemented in all of the browsers, but you can use transcompilers like Babel to convert ES6 syntax into ECMAScript 5 syntax. Babel is a transpiler. So basically, it takes ES6 syntax and give you a syntax which is a ES5 syntax. So you can run your code in all of the browsers possible. Webpack is a build tool which actually bundles all of your resources like CSS files, JS files, and it can do several kinds of modifications like transpiling your Babel code to ES5 code and all. So it bundles all of that together and give you a code which you can deploy to the server, and then you can serve that code from there and it will give you static assets. React script uses Webpack under the hood to package all of the product and give you the output project which you can deploy to the server. Create React app. So this is a utility designed by guys at Facebook and other community members so as to give other person a facility to start a new React project along with an open-ended set of defaults. So it creates your starter project in which you get the files which are essential to boot up a production-ready React system on which you can build upon. JSX. So JSX is a mechanism of writing React component using XML-like notation. You can use transpilers like Babel to transpile your code from JSX to ECMAScript 5 and deploy it to all of the browsers and anywhere you want to run your application on. So you can use it to install packages from NPM registry. So it's an alternative to NPM. So I hope that now you are aware of the basic terms and things we use in React ecosystem. So with that, this is your guy Rajat Saxena signing off. And in case you are interested in more videos like this one, make sure to give this video a thumbs up so that I will give a hint that, okay, I need to produce more videos like this one. And make sure to subscribe to Rain Studios YouTube channel so as to learn more about other web technologies and mobile technologies. Take care. Bye-bye.